this is the kind of day you really do need some comfort food. And for a lot of people here in North Carolina, the most comforting food this time of year is a big old bowl of Brunswick stew.
Yes.
Mark Little is here. You make yours in-house here at Bibs.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
It's really a traditional thing in North Carolina, Virginia. Mm-hmm. For people who may have been living under a rock, what is the basics of Brunswick stew?
Well, you know, Brunswick stew here is all of our goodness, which is pretty much all of our meats, mm-hmm. all in a stew. Some people will change it up. Some people just put chicken and pulled pork. Some people put wild game in it. But I just like to take all of our flavors, which literally this is everything that we smoke, maybe minus the turkey and the meatloaf, and it just adds a nice smokiness to the stew that you can't get any other way. You're going to start it like you do any other soup or stew. You're going to start with sautéing your onions and your celery. I don't do the Trinity. I don't add the carrots, but onion, celery, sauté that with some butter. And then you just start adding your moist ingredients, your chicken broth, your ketchup, your Worcestershire sauce. I use some Texas Pete ketchup, diced tomatoes, some things that people like to kind of keep close to them.
Yeah, there's secret
recipes. Exactly.
You can kind of experiment.
You can
experiment. There's no, like, one way to do it.
They're really, I mean, you can eat Brunswick stew in 10 different places and it all be different.
Do you choose to do a succotash for your vegetables?
Well, to me, the succotash is kind of a staple mm-hmm. to Brunswick stew. You can adjust all this other stuff, but personally, if you don't have the succotash, you don't have Brunswick stew.
Okay.
You've got soup. Yes.
And you want it to be this thick consistency.
Yes, and I make a roux to make mine thick, so it is like a stew and not a soup. And we are actually serving this now at Bibs, so you can get a bowl of it, you can get it as a side, you can get a pint or a quart. And if you get a bowl of it, you're going to get some of our world-famous hush puppies with it.
So you pull all the meat, and put it in there. Is that the last
yes.
thing you're going to put in?
The meat is the very last thing that goes in after the stew comes together, after the succotash has been added. I get all my flavors right, and then I finish it off with the smokiness of the meat.
And do you want that stew to kind of simmer and come together for a little
It'll
bit?
It'll simmer for a good 45 minutes to an hour, just
Yum.
Nice and slow, just to kind of extract some of this flavor out of the meat.
Which,
you know, it has our rubs on it. It's
right.
got the hickory smoke. So give that time to kind of make its way through the neighborhood, kind of thing.
Well, that is a whole plate of bowl of
yes.
comfort beside the plate full of comfort. So,
yes.
Mark, thank you so much. So maybe we all should try a little heat in our Brunswick stew today.
Absolutely.
To get this snow out of here.